And now, another hour of the Motown Story with John Trenton.
WTMA, Charleston.
From the start, Gordy viewed the company's basic business as the production and distribution not merely of pop records, but of hits. He refuses to sign contracts with singers and groups that require the company to release a minimum number of their records each year in order to keep their names before the public. Gordy feels that this practice, common in the music industry, is self-defeating if it means releasing a record that won't be a hit. Aside from the loss of reputation, the company is out the cost of manufacturing and distribution costs. Motown is the industry leader as far as having the greatest percentage of hits for number of releases. Levi Stubbs now, the Four Tops, talks about the hit record, Standing in the Shadows of Love.
It's hard for me to describe that tune. At first, I couldn't get a feeling for it, you know, because my interpretation of Standing in the Shadows of Love was rather vague. I just couldn't come up with it. So it took me two or three days I listened to it, took it home and lived with it, you know, and after a while, it seemed to start, you know, materializing, and fortunately it happened. And I might add, it's one of our favorites too.
Standing in the shadows of love, I'm getting ready for the heartaches to come. Can't you see me standing in the shadows of love? I'm getting ready for the heartaches to come. I wanna run, but there's nowhere to go, 'cause heartaches will follow me, I know. Without your love, the love I need, it's the beginning of the end for me. 'Cause you're taking away all my reasons for living when you pushed aside all the love I've been giving. Now wait a minute, didn't I treat you right now, baby? Didn't I do the best I could? Now didn't I? So don't you leave me standing.
Bernadette is a tune that I didn't think I could do at all. You know, it really didn't have a message to me until there was an Italian fellow that came over and to teach us some Italian lyrics to this particular tune. And through his explaining, about what some of the various words meant, you know, and the significance of them in Italian, it gave me a better outlook on the thing. And through that, I was able to get a little message across, I'd say.
On their minds, they pretend to be
Aside from the fact that a record might sound great, it needs airplay on the nation's radio stations to assure profitable sales. For companies such as Motown, the job of getting airplay rests with its own promotion men and those of its distributors. These men call at stations to deliver new releases and a sales talk on the record. However, program directors are flooded each week with many new releases from all the companies, many times numbering over 100 new singles each week. Most contemporary stations only add 4 or 5 new records each week, and some not that many. Even if they like a new record, especially by an unknown group, they'll hold back and wait for initial response on the record from another area. Many times within a week, a company can tell whether a record is going to make it or not. Martha Reeves now talks about the recording Jimmy Mack, an instant hit.
Jimmy Mack was really thrilling. You know, because at first I was wondering, like, you probably are, who is Jimmy Mack? But he's just a name. And the surprising thing about it, I met about 6 Jimmy Macks after we recorded it. It was the grooviest beat we'd ever had, I think, as far as records are concerned. And all the kids liked it. And wherever I'd go, anywhere, the kids would sing it for me, or they'd demand that we sing it. If we left it out of our repertoire, they'd have a fit. So it's one of our biggest.
Was growing up now, and with each record, he got better. Listen to Traveling Man as the Motown story continues.
Something deep inside of me keeps me moving aimlessly. I've always been, I'll always be a lonely traveling man. Something that I can't explain molded me. Traveling man, I'm
Gladys Knight of the Pips talks about the group's first performance, and you'll hear I Heard It Through the Grapevine, Motown's biggest seller to that date.
My first date that we sang professionally was at the Y, the YWCA, for a tea. And it came off all right. And from there, it seemed like things, we just got nice breaks and so forth. And we didn't have a name at the time. Everybody's assignment was to go home and try to come up with a name that would kind of suit the group. You know, we thought of flowers and animals and all that kind of stuff. But we couldn't come up with anything that really caught everybody's fancy, you might say. So James Woods, being our cousin and had done so much for the group, we just decided that we could name ourselves the Pips because that was his nickname at the time. And whenever we would go on a program, we just, they would announce us as, "Here they are, ladies and gentlemen, the Pips." I heard it through the grapevine. I really believe that that was the key to our whole future. You know, like, records can determine your future, and I believe that this was the major record that started our careers really to moving probably over the fence and open doors for Gladys Knight and the Pips.
Second, that emotion was, this is one of those tunes that the punchline came from actually what was a mistake, because this guy, Al Cleveland, who is the co-writer on the song, and I were in a department store, and something happened between he and the waitress. He meant to say, "I second the motion," or something, you know, and he said, "I second that emotion," you know, and we started laughing about it. And on the way out of the store, we just thought it'd be a good thing to write a song about.
Maybe you wanna give me kisses
1967, for the first time, the Motown record label reads Diana Ross and the Supremes.
This is when Holland Dozier Holland decided to go more mechanical and do weird sounds and things like that. And I believe it came about because of the Beatle era, which everyone, writers, producers, singers, were influenced by the Beatles quite a bit, I must say, even though they are and were doing things that people have been doing all the time, but they were the ones who made it more interesting so the masses could really enjoy things. And Reflections is a very weird, weird song. You hear those tick, 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 besides the voices, you know.
The mirror of my mind, time after time, I see reflections of you and me, reflections of the way life used to be, reflections of the love you took from me. Oh, I'm all alone now, no love to shield me, trapped in a world that's a distorted reality. From me and left me alone with only memories. Through the mirror of my mind, through these tears that I'm crying, reflects the hurt I can't control. Cause although you're gone, I keep holding on to the happy time. Ooh, and you know, as I peer through the window of lost time, looking over my yesterday and all the love I gave, all is me. All the love that I've wasted, all the tears that I've tasted, all is me. Through the hollow of my tears, I see a dream that's lost. From the hurt that you have caused, everywhere I turn, seems like everything I see reflects the love that used to be.
Otis Williams of the Temptations talks about the Temps hit I Wish It Would Rain.
That's one we really debated on and had a lot of conversation about. This here a little bit about the birds singing and a little bit of thundering and all that bit. That goes back into that creative area again. But we said, no, man, that's, you know, that's what makes people talk about, hey, what is that? Let me hear that again. And by the song being with the story, you know, it had, that just made them really listen.
Sunshine, blue skies, please go away. A girl has found another and gone away. With her went my future. My life is filled with gloom. So day after day, I stay locked up in my room. I know to you, it might sound strange, but I wish it would rain. Supposed to cry. Listen, I gotta cry, 'cause crying eases the pain. Oh yeah, people, this hurt I feel inside, words could never explain. I just wish it would rain. Oh, let it rain, rain, rain. Stained face, pressed against the window pane. My eyes search the skies, desperately for rain. 'Cause raindrops behind my teardrop, and no one will ever know that I'm crying, crying. When I go outside to the world outside my tears, I refuse to explain. Oh, I wish it would rain.
It was 1968, and the Supremes needed a hit. They got it with Love Child.
There was a long time between Reflections and Love Child. The Supremes had been off for quite a while, and they decided we all got to buckle down together and get a hit record.
I would like to do a combination of many kinds of songs. I don't believe in just sticking to one particular thing. I would like to appeal to many, many different people and to show them as many sides of music as possible.
For once in my life, I have someone who needs me, someone I've needed so long. For once unafraid, I can go where life leads me. Somehow I know I'll be strong. For once I can touch what my heart used to dream of long before I do. Someone warm like you would make my dream come true. Yeah, yeah, yeah. For once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me. Not like it's hurt me before. For once, I have something I know won't desert me. I'm not alone anymore.
And for once in my life, a new member now joins the Temptations. And it's a new bag for them, record-wise, too.
Right at the time, again, we were going through a group transition with from David Ruffin to Dennis Edwards. And at this time, we said, hey, man, why don't we get on this new sound with the psych thing? And so we recorded because that's when the wah-wah was in and a driving beat. But it was a different sound also at the time. And this is what, like I said, this is what we look for, something that's different. And we recorded it, and I don't know, we was kind of straddling the fence for a minute, some of us, because we didn't know, because like a lot of people thought we were talking about getting high, which we weren't. We were talking about just a state of being. You know, but it's just the way the business is. Sometimes you have to make a move, and a lot of people just can't understand at the time, but this is the way Cloud Nine came about, and we've been lucky in this vein ever since then.
See, I was born and raised in the slums of a city. It was a one-room shack that slept in another chair beside me. We hardly had enough food or room to sleep. It was hard time. Needed something to eat my trouble, man. Listen, my father didn't know the meaning of work. He disrespected mama and treated us like dirt. I left home seeking a job that I never did find. Depressed and downhearted, I took the cloud nine. I'm doing fine up here on cloud nine. Listen, one more time. I'm doing fine up here on cloud nine. Folks down there tell me, they say give yourself a chance, son. Don't let life pass you by. But the world of reality is a rat race where only the strongest survive. It's a dog-eat-dog world that ain't no lie.
Ain't no lie.
It ain't even safe no more.
difference between day and night.
Next step in the Motown story, the Temptations join the Supremes. It's more Motown magic, and another hit is made.
I'm gonna make you love me along with the Temps. We all got together at a session, and it's so much fun working with the boy groups because you kind of put them up tight and they put you up tight. In other words, it was like a challenge and everybody was trying to outdo everybody, so you came up with some great material, especially like an ad-libs and endings and stuff like that.
I'm gonna do all the things for you a girl wants a man to do. Oh, baby,
baby.
I'll sacrifice for you. I'll even do wrong for you. Oh, baby.
Show.
And I'm gonna use every trick in the book. I'll try my best to get you hooked. Hey, baby.
Take me, I'm yours.
Every breath I take and each and every step I make brings me closer, baby, closer to you.
And with each beat of my heart, for every day we apart, I'll hunger for every wasted hour.
And I-
Marvin Gaye re-records the Gladys Knight record, I Heard It Through the Grapevine. Marvin's recording sells almost 4 million copies and becomes bigger than ever, Motown's biggest.
After recording it, I had no idea that it was going to sell as many records as it did. In fact, I wasn't too optimistic about it at all. I had no idea that it would be released and that it would sell nearly 4 million records.
Marvin Gaye, and I heard it through the grapevine. Junior Walker said no to recording. What does it take to win your love?
I said, well, I don't know, man. So I wouldn't record it that year. And he came back the next year. You know, he said, well, man, still got that record. So I said, you still got the record, huh? He said, yeah, you gonna record it? I said, well, what is it? He said, what does it take to win your love? I said, okay, man, let's go and see. So we went over and we started the recording. I told him, I said, man, this ain't my bag, man. You know, we got to arguing. I said, this ain't my bag. He said, would you just record the record, Junior? I said, all right, man.
In 1969, Motown Records debuted The Originals.
We started rehearsing, kicking a few things around, and we got a very good sound. And saw Mr. Gordon one day, and I told him the idea that we'd like to get with the company. And we came over, we started as background singers. They used us as background singers for about 2 or 3 years. And everybody started asking, you know, why didn't they record us? And finally, they tried a couple of things on us, and they turned out pretty nice. Baby, I'm For Real, you know, well, it's a ballad type thing, you know, and it was a new thing for, you know, for the company and for us also, I would say.
Baby, baby, you don't understand how much I love you, baby, and how much I wanna be your only man. Oh, baby. Baby, 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 you don't have to go. Stay a little while longer, baby. I wanna talk to you just a little more. I see the little tears in your eyes about to fall. You are wondering if I'm for real. If you cry, I wonder why you cry. I tell you, no, this is how I feel.
Originals and Baby, I'm For Real. Diana Ross discovered the Jackson 5, and until that time, no other group had surpassed the super success of the Supremes. But the Jackson 5 has, and in such a short time. Already they have sold over 10 million records and have been dominating the number one hit spot.
When I first started singing, I was 5. We did this show in Gary for the Mayor. You know, it's like a talent show. So Diane, she was sitting in the audience. She happened to see us. She thought we was good, so she came backstage and talked to us. She said, bring us to Motown. So when Motown saw our act, they liked it.
Jackson 5, with a hit that started it all for them, I Want You Back. This is the Motown Story.
I don't know what that is on the beginning of Psychedelic Shack, because it has that funny yow sound and then it goes into the beat, you know. But I've learned by being in the business and being around that the record-buying people, they like things that's different in sounds, unusual.
Hold it. Yeah.
The Jackson 5 now does two more of their giant hit records. Magic touch of the Jackson 5 as the Motown story continues.
Just like back to grade school.
almost inevitably, it had to end. Diana Ross was leaving the Supremes to go it alone. Here's her farewell performance with the Supremes, captured in a live performance.
A lot of different things to a lot of different people. In other words, different strokes for different folks. Well, to me it means in the next coming year, Mary and Cindy and I won't be together, but we'll always be together in our hearts. Say it. Someday we'll be together. Oh yeah. And if you have a loved one or someone that is not with you at this time and you'd like them to be here, whatever the reason may be, if you want to just hum along with me or just think about it. We'll be together. Yes, we will. Yes, we will. I know. Some sweet day. Yes, we will. Yes, we will.
The new Supremes now consisted of Gene Terrell, Cindy Birdsong, and Mary Wilson.
We had quite a time coming up with a record that would be suitable and would live up to the standards and yet still be different, because even with Dinah Ross and the Supremes, things had to change. Even if Dinah stayed, we had to maybe not get a new sound but change our style a little bit. So Up the Ladder to the Roof is different, but yet and still it's still the Supremes, you know, and Gene does a great job on the song, and it's also a message song, sort of hidden in there, and you can take it anywhere you want to take it, but it still leads to happiness and peace because you're closer to heaven.
We shall run across the sky and illuminate the night.
The new Supremes in action for the first time and their first hit, Up the Ladder to the Roof. Diana Ross rose from the neighborhoods of Detroit to superstardom. Here she is again to talk about Reach Out and Touch Somebody's Hand.
Barry Gordy didn't particularly want to release Reach Out and Touch because Reach Out and Touch is a waltz, and they're not usually the kind of songs that really sell. But the way the situation in the world and everything was going, I felt like I wanted to have some sort of message. And I was very interested in the drug scene in Detroit because young kids in Detroit were getting very, very involved in drugs, and I was trying to send out a message to the families and things for them to, you know, try to give a helping hand to these kids and get them back on the right track. And then I was very surprised to see that Reach Out and Touch got to be a good enough smash for me to get a start and to, you know, begin to try to find where my head is. Anything I do is going to be sincere. It's going to be me.
Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place if you can. Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place if you can.
Just try.
Seems fitting to have Diana Ross end this era of the Motown success story. Her every performance fills the air with excitement. In such an uncertain business as show business, it's almost a certainty that no one knows what lies on the horizon. It's a new decade for Motown. They've already racked up an impressive number of successes. The Motown hits just keep on coming.
Thank you.
call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far. Just call my name, I'll be there in a hurry. On that you can depend and never worry. You see, my love is alive. It's like a seed that only needs the thought of you to grow. So if you feel the need for company, please, my darling, let it be me. To express the depth of the love I feel for you. But a writer put it very nicely. When he was away from the one he loved, he sat down and wrote these words.
No wind,
no wind,
no rain,
no rain.
Oh, winter's cold.
Remember, life holds for you one guarantee. You'll always have me. And if you should miss my lover one of these old days, if you should ever miss the arms that used to hold you so close, or the lips that used to touch yours so tenderly,